Hi, welcome to Techie Time. Today we are going to do MOSFET drain and transfer characteristics in LTSpice. I open a new schematic. You are going to place the components. Go to first we are going to do MOSFET drain characteristics. Okay, so we'll pick a MOSFET from the components. So NMOS is the keyword for that. Place it. Escape for voltage source. Battery is taken. We need two batteries, one in the input side and one in the output side. A common ground is taken and placed. Do the connections using the yellow colored wire. So now the connections are made, plus escape. Now this voltage source is named VGS. Since it's between the gate and the source, this is named VDS. Since it's between the drain and the source, this voltage source is given a value of 10 volt and VDS is given a value of 20 volt initially. Now we are going to do drain characteristics. Drain characteristics is drawn for VDS and the output drain current, keeping VGS constant. So simulate edit simulation command in DC speed. The first source should be the one which should be in x-axis. VDS should be in x-axis since we are doing drain characteristics. So first source is VDS, linear sweep, start value from 0 till 20 with an increment of 1, and second source is VGS linear from 0 till 5 with an increment of 1 and okay. Now we'll run the circuit. You're going to plot the drain current, add traces. ID of M1 gives the drain current. So this is the drain characteristics. For different VGS constant values from 0 to 5 with an increment of 1, it's drawn for VDS in x-axis and ID in y-axis. So as the VDS voltage increases, ID increases and then gets constant. Next we are going to do the transfer characteristics. So we are going to change only the simulation command. Second source is not required. First source should be VGS from 0 till 10 with an increment of 1. Transfer characteristics is going to be drawn for VGS and ID, keeping VDS constant at 20 volt now. So add traces and ID of M1 is plotted. So this is the transfer characteristics. It's drawn for VGS in x-axis and ID in y-axis at constant VDS. So we can try it for different VDS values also. So if you'd like the video, kindly like, share and subscribe. Thank you.